Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And lately I've been getting a lot of questions about, Patrick, I can't download my model, but I need to change or add new measures to the model. How do you do it? Well, in this video, I'm gonna show you. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date on all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, can't download your model anymore, and for some reason you don't have a PBIX file. What do? You need to add some measures to it. Well, I'm gonna show you in this video. So just a little caution, you do need premium or premium per user to do this. So if you're using pro, you probably won't run into this problem. But if you have premium or premium per user, probably doing some things with the XMLA endpoint that prevents you from downloading this model. So in this video, I'm gonna show you how to add some measures or change some measures. So you guys know how we like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So take for example, someone says, hey, there's something wrong with the measure, and you go to your model, here's my model, click it and choose download the file. And it gives you a really good error. It says you can't download this file because the data set was altered through the XMLA endpoint. So someone changed this model using some other tool besides Power BI Desktop. What you can do is you can use Tabular Editor 2 or Tabular Editor 3. I'm gonna use Tabular Editor 2. You can download either one. 2 is free, that's why I'm using 2. And you go back over to your workspace and you grab the XMLA endpoint. So you go to workspace, choose settings, go to premium and copy it. Then you head back to Tabular Editor and you do this, see that little icon? Open Tabular model from existing database, and you paste your XMLA endpoint in right there. Choose Windows Integrated or Azure AD Login and click OK. You'll have to go through an authentication process. You get a list of the databases, the models in that workspace. So just go ahead and find yours, click it, and choose OK. Once you do that, you'll be connected to the model. Now, I was curious. I went back to the person that was using this data set, and I'm like, how do you know the measure is not correct? And there's like two reasons. You have this measure called freight and tax, and I'm assuming that's the, you know, the sum of total freight and total tax. It doesn't add up. But what we also notice, and they were showing me this, is when you hover over this measure, you added the measure definition, and it looks like you're adding tax twice. I was like, oh, okay. So head back over to Tabular Editor and go to Tables and go to Internet Sales. That's where that measure is. And I have two folders here. And then I'm gonna choose freight and tax. And I can see the definition of that measure, and it's definitely wrong. I'm gonna go ahead and type freight. And then I'm gonna go down here in my description and also type freight. You can spell it right, okay? And then there's a button right here that says save changes to the connected database. I'm gonna go ahead and press that. And when I do that, if I return to my model and I go ahead and refresh, these numbers right here should change. There they go, they match. And if I go hover over this again, you can see that my model definition in my description changes. I got some questions like, hey, do I need to process my model now? No, because it's a measure. It just picks it up because that measure is calculated dynamically whenever you pull it on the page. Well, if I add relationships, if I add new tables, if I add columns to table, probably have to reprocess either the model or some portion of the model. All right, what do you guys think? You got any questions, you got any comments? You ran this before? I'd love to know. You know what to do. Post your questions in the comments below. It's your first time video. The Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.